Did you know that around 1.1 million people are living in the United States with HIV today? And about 1 in 7 don't even know that they're infected. Today, we're going beyond the stigma and discussing HIV and AIDS. In a world of cancel culture and fake news, we're often faced with a lot of misinformation. Just a few weeks back, heavy discussions surrounding HIV and AIDS were present front and center to the globe after a rapper made some false claims between the AIDS virus and the LGBTQ plus community, as well as other claims that HIV can lead to one's death in just a few weeks' time. That's why today we are talking about this topic and setting the record straight. Contrary to popular belief, AIDS isn't a gay disease. In fact, around the world, most sexually transmitted cases of HIV, the virus that causes AIDS, are spread through heterosexual intercourse, as well as other ways that you probably didn't even know about. Today, we're going to go into all of this a lot more. But first, hey everyone, I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner. I'm an emergency room doctor who treats everything from COVID to gunshot wounds, burns, you name it. I've created this video series to help answer some of your medical questions and the questions that I get from patients each and every day. If you find this video helpful, please do me a favor and subscribe. HIV, the virus that causes AIDS, is one of the world's most serious public health challenges of our time. And the misinformation and stigma surrounding the topic is usually based on a lack of understanding on a scientific level. That's why today we're talking about it. In fact, there were approximately 37.6 million individuals across the globe with HIV in 2020. Of these, 35.9 million were adults and 1.7 million were children, according to the World Health Organization. Now, how does HIV spread? Who's at risk? Is there a cure? Don't worry, I'm going to break down all of that for you. But first things first. What is HIV? HIV stands for human immunodeficiency virus. It harms your immune system by destroying a type of white blood cell that helps your body fight infections. This puts you at risk for serious infections and certain cancers. If left untreated, HIV can lead to the disease AIDS. What is AIDS, you may ask? Well, AIDS stands for acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. It's the final stage of infection with HIV. It happens when your body's immune system is so badly damaged because of the virus. It can lead to serious health complications and even death. However, it should be noted that not everyone with HIV develops AIDS. How does HIV spread? HIV can spread in many different ways. The most common way HIV is spread is through unprotected sex with a person with HIV. But that being said, it can also, in some cases, be spread by sharing drug needles or through contact with the blood of a person with HIV, or babies can even get it from their mother during pregnancy, childbirth, or breastfeeding. How HIV doesn't spread, you can't become infected with HIV through ordinary contact. That means you can't catch HIV or AIDS by hugging, kissing, dancing, or shaking your hands with somebody who has the infection. HIV is also not spread through the air, water, or insect bites. Who is at risk for getting HIV? Anyone of any age, race, sex, or sexual orientation can be infected with HIV/AIDS. Let me say that again. Anyone can be at risk. However, certain individuals are at greater risk. Individuals who have another sexually transmitted disease, or what we call STIs now, having an STI can actually increase your risk of getting or spreading HIV. Some STIs can cause inflammation and sores, which can make it easier for HIV to get into the body. Who else can be at risk? Individuals who use IV drugs or even share needles, and individuals who engage in risky sexual behaviors, such as not using condoms. What are the symptoms of HIV/AIDS you should be aware of? The first signs of HIV infection may be flu-like symptoms such as fever, chills, muscle aches, and fatigue, which are common amongst viruses in general. These symptoms may come and go within 2 to 4 weeks. This stage is called acute HIV infection. If the infection is not treated, it becomes chronic HIV infection. Often, there are no symptoms during this stage. If it is not treated, eventually the virus will weaken your body's immune system. Then the infection will progress to AIDS. This is the late stage of the HIV infection. With AIDS, your immune system is badly damaged. You can get more and more severe infections. These are known as opportunistic infections. Many opportunistic infections are considered AIDS-defining conditions. That means if a person with HIV has one of these conditions, they are diagnosed with AIDS. The other way AIDS is diagnosed is having a CD4 cell count below 200 cells per milliliter of blood. These opportunistic infections include a wide variety of bacterial, fungal, and protozoal infections, which include toxoplasma, pneumocystis, cryptococcus neoforms, mycobacterium avium, mycobacterium tuberculosis, cytomegalovirus, herpes simplex viruses, histoplasmosis, just to name a few. Some individuals may not feel sick during the early stages of HIV infection, so the only way to know for sure whether you have HIV is to get tested. How do you know if you have HIV? A blood test. A blood test can be conducted to tell if you have HIV. Your doctor can do the test, or you can use a home testing kit. These are the most sure ways of detection. Typically, it's an ELISA test, and if that's positive, it's confirmed with a Western blot test. There are also viral load tests of the blood, as well as saliva tests. What are the treatments for HIV/AIDS? Unfortunately, at this time, there's no cure for the HIV infection. However, that being said, that doesn't mean that it's a death sentence either. AIDS and HIV can be controlled and treated with medications. This type of treatment is often referred to as antiretroviral therapy, or ART. ART can make HIV a manageable chronic condition. It also reduces the risk of spreading the virus to others. By taking these medications as prescribed, infected individuals can get to a level where the virus is not even detectable on their tests or in their system. But if you stop the medications, the virus comes right back, and now you might even be resistant to the medications that you were taking. Most individuals with HIV nowadays live a long and healthy life if they get and stay on antiretroviral therapy. This being said, it is also important to take care of yourself physically and emotionally as well. Making sure that you have the support you need, continuing to live a healthy lifestyle, and getting regular medical care all can help you enjoy a better quality of life. Can HIV/AIDS be prevented? Yes. You can reduce the risk of spreading HIV by regularly getting tested for HIV and STIs and by choosing less risky sexual behaviors. This includes limiting the number of sexual partners you have and using latex condoms every time you have sex. If you or your partner is allergic to latex, you can always opt for polyurethane condoms instead. There are also medications out there for individuals who don't already have HIV, but are at high risk. The first being pre-exposure prophylaxis. Pre-exposure prophylaxis is for people who don't already have HIV, but are at very high risk of getting it. This is taken as a daily medication to reduce risk. The second preventative medication is post-exposure prophylaxis. This is for people who have possibly been exposed to HIV. It is only for emergency situations. You must start it within 72 hours after possible exposure to HIV, and typically is given for 28 days. All right, that's been an HIV and AIDS breakdown with me, Dr. Wagner. As always, let me know in the comments if you have any questions surrounding HIV/AIDS that I maybe didn't cover today, but could do a follow-up video on. Also, please make sure that you subscribe and turn your bell notifications on. When you do that and you hit that like button, you let YouTube know that you'd like to see more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching, and stay healthy, my friends.